हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रमन गुप्ता फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज बारा। इन दिस वीडियो वील स्टडी द एसे ऑन गोइंग अ जर्नी रिटन बाय विलियम हैजलिट। दिस एसे इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट। द फर्स्ट पॉइंट डिस्कस्ड इन दिस एसे इज प्रेज ऑफ अ जर्नी। द ऑथर प्रेजेस जर्नी। The writer begins with praise of a journey. He expresses delight in journeying alone, with nature being his only companion. He hates being in the company of fellow travelers, who like to chat and worry about the world when they travel. He loves his solitude and freedom. The author likes journey, but alone, because if there is someone with you cannot enjoy the company of nature and solitude. He will chat and will make you disturb. A journey should be liberating oneself from the everyday world and its concerns, to remove oneself from the prison of company and anxieties. One must become connected to nature. The only way to achieve such a union is through complete freedom of thought. He enjoys the silent commentary of wild flowers or the music of flowing waters, that constant repartee with fellow or worldly topics. Such freedom does not demand a confession of feelings in words or gestures. He claims that when we are with others, we should completely devote our attention to them and entertain their thoughts and opinions. However, when we are alone, and traveling, we should just concentrate on our own thoughts and reflect on them. We can either be alone or together, not both at the same time. We cannot talk and reflect at the same time. We cannot converse and have internal thoughts at the same time. The next point is with nature. When one is with nature, he must lose all thoughts of collecting and analyzing information. One must experience and not judge or evaluate such experience. However, when we have the company of another person, we always have to express our experience into hasty words. Then one has to make such information relevant to them, express it in a way they can understand. This creates tension and a need to satisfy other people's anxiety. This way you can never truly immerse yourself in the natural environment around you. The right praise Samuel Taylor Coleridge, who could experience and narrate such experience at the same time without flaws and corruption. He could instinctively translate his enjoyment into words. However, the writer admits his incapacity to do the same. He has to ponder and think for hours before he can put his thoughts on paper. He says there is only one topic where it is good to have company on travel, and that is regarded food and meals. However, even then, the sheer enjoyment of a warm meat at the end of a taxing journey can truly be experienced alone. The next point is joy of solitude. The writer believes all the forms of ecstasy that a journey offers can truly be enjoyed in solitude. One can be greedy in such a setting, allowing oneself to sing, dance, and be free without being judged. The pure joy of delicious food and appetizing smells coming from a steaming pot of food should not be wasted over a cheap conversation. He claims when you ignore your fellow travelers, you are ignoring your own grievances and worries. You are unidentifiable and almost invisible. You do not have to be the person everyone knows you to be. You can lose your very identity, and with it your inhibitions, biases, and preferences. Hence, one is free to indulge in new company . He recalls many musings he has had on lonely visits to any place. The next point is travel makes memories. He goes on to discuss the unpredictable nature of one's travel and experiences. A change of space can change our whole perspective altogether. We make new memories in place of old ones, new moments in place of the past ones. There is a constant shifting of viewpoints and perspectives. When we are in a place, it may seem like the whole world, and when we move to a different one, we find a new world entirely. Thus, we create and register an unending list of places and things. And when we return to old places, we remember and revisit those old memories of the same place. When one is traveling alone, the journey becomes more important than the destination itself. It is more about how how a man travels. The last point is familiar company. He confesses that when he travels to foreign lands with a different language, he does like a familiar company. However, he claims he loved being in France, where hardly anyone spoke English. He found to be liberating and enriching to be in a land of a different tongue. Therefore, foreign travel can challenge our limitations and learn more about yourself. It takes you out of your comfort zone and helps you to grow as a human being. When you don't find everything you are familiar with, you develop yourself, you search a human being in yourself, you grow it. However, he claims that no matter how long and enjoyable the journey, it always ends at home. That the real enjoyment is at home. Every person, no matter how much she enjoys traveling, yearns for a return to the homestead in the end. If he could travel for life, he would still find another life to spend. So this is all about this essay. Thank you.